So tonight we're just going to be painting a step-by-step landscape with a river here and some clouds here. It's a scene from Tasmania from the Overland Track. So we're just going to do that step-by-step. So I'm just using a mix of cobalt blue and light red to just bring in some bits of the sky. And if you've watched any of my previous videos before, then you'll know that I use that colour quite a bit. Better make sure my head stays out of the way. And then what we're going to do as well is just bring in some of that down into here, down into this area here, down into this water. I don't know if you can see, but I've done a bit of a sketch here so we know where we're going, what we're doing. So you don't really need to do very much. That's the nice thing about painting wet in wet, is that you can really just, you know, leave the sky to paint itself. So while it's still wet, we might just bring in a little bit of yellow ochre into these areas here. Cobalt blue. We might just Alright, so I'm just going to dry this. So I've sketched in this mountain range here, and I'm just going to bring in so I'm just going to start fairly light, and I'm just going to tilt this up a little bit just to help with the flow of the water. And I might just purposefully just I've just loaded up with a slightly stronger wash. I've just got the same again, same wash again, just a little bit dark. Bring that around there. Now I'm just loading up the brush with just fresh water. I'm just going to just feather that down slightly. Just just to help with that idea of reflections. Start on the edge of the water there. And a bit, we might just darken that again. Same again here. Just going to bring accentuating that line a bit more. I'm just bringing in a mix of Winsor blue, red shade and light red. Just to darken that even further. All right, let's just try this. I'm just adding some cerulean blue here. Alright, we're just going to dry this. So we're just going to bring in the rock that's here. Just nice and light to begin with, and then we'll just add a bit more. Just using some Paynes Grey, a pretty thick mix of Paynes Grey there, to just darken this. So I'm going to try and pull this all together now, which will be interesting. We'll see how that goes, eh? think the last thing I'll probably do as well is just break up this edge here a little bit, just because it's kind of nicer for the eye to be led. Be led into the picture. So the very last thing I'm going to do is just lift out see these armatures coming in, clouds a bit, this one here, so it takes your eye in and then along this and then probably back up here, you know, and then there's not too much here, so you probably come around here. But definitely the subject really, which is probably a little bit too much kind of in the middle. I probably could have put that more somewhere else, but at least it's not smack bang in the middle, so it's that's probably where the subject is. But that's why, by taking the eye this way slightly and then this way and then even ending up over here a bit, that helps to not just stop here. That's this painting finished, and in terms of signing it, I will be definitely signing it down here because I don't want my signature here to spoil the subject, so I'll be putting my signature down here. But thanks for joining me tonight, and I will see you in the next video. Good night.